here the setup, which kind of setup. For example, you know, if in the family there's a person who knows that. Hello everyone, in the last session we had discussed about previous year question papers of the topic learning, and that time we discussed about, you know, we are discussing about it year wise. So this time we will be discussing about 2019 PYQ of the learning chapter. Okay, so in 2019 they asked you this question of learning, that is, what is vicarious learning? Discuss its application in the acquisition of emotional response. And the next question what they asked you was, discrimination and generalization are two complementary processes in skill learning. Now discuss with reference to operant conditioning. So now if I come to the first one that they asked you was, what is vicarious learning? Discuss its application in the acquisition of emotional responses. Now first you have to explain what is vicarious learning. So if you have done the chapter well, you must be knowing that vicarious learning is basically asking you about the observational learning. So here what you have to do is that you have to discuss about observational learning. Now, if you have been reading the chapter, so you will find that in observational learning, there is not so much of content that is given, but what they have, you know, signified in various books and all, that mostly they are representing what the Albert Bandura concept. So here what you can do is, when you are talking about observational learning, you can talk about the Albert Bandura's experiment. Now, if you know that if this is observational learning, so what is happening is that we are observing the things and then we are learning. There are certain things that you observe from your parents or from the social conditioning and then you get it into your mind. That means nobody has told you about this, but you know how it is. Why is it so? Because you have observed it and you have learned it. As I'm telling you that, you know, when you go to the Western countries, now there you find that once the, you know, the person or the child is 18 plus, so they know that they have to earn their own bread. But when it comes to India, then things are different. So you'll find that people are still, you know, struggling and people are still doing their further studies. So what I mean to say is this is coming through observational learning. There the culture is very different, here the culture is very different. So if you want, you can explain it with reference to the culture. If you don't want, then fine enough, you can just give your definition with respect to Albert Bandura's experiment. Now, once you have explained what is vicarious learning, they tell you what? Discuss its application in the acquisition of emotional responses. Now, what is happening is that they have specifically mentioned that we don't want anything else, you know, with respect to the answer. What they said is that how emotional regulation pattern can happen. Now, as you people have been preparing for civil services, you must be going through, you know, ups and downs. And what are those? For example, sometimes you are happy. Why? Because you have completed the syllabus or you have completed a topic, but then you are at a low phase also. Why? Because you're not able to channelize your preparation. So that way what is happening is that how you are going to balance your emotion, because it's a marathon, it's not a sprint. So that time, more than you know, your aptitude, it's your attitude that is going to matter. So what is going to happen is that they are asking you through observation how emotional responses you know, can be learned. So what you can do is that you can talk about various aspects. For example, if I talk about media, it could be anything. It could be social media, it could be TV media, it could be your movies, etc. What are they telling you? Now, through those media, you are learning so many things. Even your emotional responses to the factor is also not yours. It is something which is learned, right? How or why am I saying this? Is, for example, if you are watching some horror movie, what is happening is that now this movie has told you what, that if this kind of creature or if this kind of hypothetical creation comes in front of you, what is going to happen? You have to react this way. So even your reactions, are learned. Now what is and which reference I have given you? I have given you the reference of media. Here if I give you an example, it could be you know, at present what I have seen is your movie Bhool Bhulaiya. Fine. Now other than that, if there is a child, right, and if the child sees that when there is a lot of disturbance that is coming in the family and the parents are keeping their emotional self very strong, so what happens is that the child gets conditioned in that manner, and the child has learned that even though if there is so high or low in life, what is going to happen is that nothing is going to matter in long run. What matters is that how emotionally resilient you are. So for that matter, the child is learning this behavior from their parents. So here what you can say is that even the parents' reaction to their problems, parents' reaction to the problem is learnt by the child. Example, you know, how to handle stressful situations. Now, if I come to here, the setup, which kind of setup? For example, if in the family there's a person who knows that, if you are very, very low, in a very low phase of your life, what is going to happen is that how strong you have to hold yourself. There also what is going to happen or what is, going to affect you is observational learning. How? Because once you are there, you will learn about what? How to handle depression, how to handle sadness. Now, if it's a family where, two children are there, what is going to happen if the elder sibling is, an achiever? So what is going to happen? The younger sibling will always learn from this stat that when you do well, when you perform well, so this is the kind of appreciation that you get. So there also the emotional side is learned. That means appreciation coming through hard work. Then supposingly if there are people who are in troublesome relationships, now what is happening is that the children in those families, sometimes they learn and they get very scary of this whole social setup of marriage and all. So what is happening is there also they are learning it from the family itself, that how scary some social events could be. Fine. Now, what else? In certain cases, what happened is that observe what, that this is how a civil servant should behave. So how, what happens is that once people get into service, so you'll find that there's a change in personality. Now where is this change in personality coming from? Because they have observed it, they have learned it, that once you are into the service, the life is different, so you have to behave in that manner. So there you also find what? Change in personality. Small thing doesn't matter, or small thing doesn't affect you a lot. Fine. Okay, so this was with respect to vicarious learning. You can write many more factors, but I have just given you a little glimpse of it. Now, if I come to the second question is saying discrimination and generalization are two complementary processes in skill learning discussed with reference to operant conditioning. Now, very beautiful question. Why? Because they are asking you about operant conditioning. So what you can do over here is that you first need to explain what is operant conditioning. Then you need to tell what is discrimination and what is generalization. So if I come to discrimination, what is discrimination? So discrimination is basically when, whosoever it might be, I will take an example of an animal. For example, there's a rat, right? Now, the rat knows that the rat has to press the liver. For example, this is a liver and this is a rat. So now what happens is that the rat has learned it, what? That once there is a signal, that means if the light signal is there, the rat has to push the liver. Once the, if the light is on, if the light is off, what is going to happen? The rat has to push the liver. So what is happening is that the discrimination factor, that means the rat now knows if the light is on, press the liver. The rat now knows if the light is off, don't press the liver. So this is what discrimination is. Generalization is what? For example, the light was red. The light was red when the liver need to be pressed. Now in case if the light is yellow, the rat is not able to distinguish what? That it is a yellow light. So maybe yellow means no and red meant yes. So what happens is that the rat has generalized it. That means even if the light rat has generalized it, that even if the light is red, the rat will press the liver. And even if the light is yellow, the rat will again press the liver. So you see what is happening is that the rat has generalized it that the light on, be it red or yellow, it means that you have to press the liver. So discrimination and generalization, the difference between the two is this. Now, I have explained you with reference to operant conditioning. Now they are saying that there are two complementary processes in skill learning. So now two complementary processes in learning, why? Because once you will explain this entire thing, what is going to happen is now you have to explain that this is a complementary process. Now why complementary process? Because once it's a complementary process, you need to understand that the rat has learned what? How to press the liver. Fine. Now, further training will help the rat to understand that if the light is red, then only press the liver. If it is any other color, then don't press the liver. So what is happening is that complementary process mein two things are happening: learning and with better training, with better training, what is going to happen? With better training, what is going to happen is that you need to, or you will get more refined. I have just given an experiment of rat. Here, you can go with any example. Any example, you know, there can be any human being example also. For example, if the child has learned how to play, or if the child has learned how to respond to a signal. So it is basically what responding to the stimuli. So one very important aspect of this generalization discrimination means. Responding to stimuli. Fine. This was just an overview how to attempt the question. In 2019, they have asked you these two questions. One was with respect to vicarious learning, that was observational learning. Other was with respect to operant conditioning, generalization and discrimination. Next time, we'll be coming with PYQ of 2018. Thank you so much.